An introduction to Galois theory. And all I want to do in this little introduction, well, is first show you pretty pictures. The author tries to motivate Galois theory with these two pictures, and there's a relationship between these two pictures. What are these two pictures about? This picture is a tower of fields, or lattice of subfields, of that field extension of the rationals. And we've talked about examples somewhat similar to this last Friday, not quite as complicated. Lattice of subfields of this field extension of the rationals, and a bunch of numbers associated with those. As we talked about last week, those are the degrees of the field extensions. Dimension is a vector space over the subfield. And what is this? This is a sort of taking this lattice, subfield lattice, and inverting it, so to speak, to make this picture. And what are all these things? Here, 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 here. Those fields, they don't look like they're fields, do they? They look like they're finite sets. And in fact, they are groups. Group theory applied to field theory is what Galois theory is all about. What groups? They're called Galois groups. What else would they be called? What are Galois groups? That's the subject for Wednesday, but let's look at the definition right away, because I was thinking there was a previous definition. But we're not going to fully understand this definition today by any means, okay? Let E be an extension field of F. So F is the smaller field, E is the bigger one containing F. And automorphism, really? An automorphism of E is a ring isomorphism from E onto E. Okay, that's not too bad. The Galois group of E over F, Gal E over F, is what? Is the set of all automorphisms E that take every element of F to itself. Fix all the elements of F. Okay, here's what we should do just to finish class today, is do an example. What is the Galois group of our favorite field extension, Q adjoined square root of 2 over Q? It's the set of all automorphisms of E that take every element of F to itself. So this must be the set of all automorphisms of Q adjoining square root of 2, ring isomorphisms that map Q adjoining square root of 2 to itself, that map every rational number to itself. That is a group under function composition. The elements of the Galois group are functions. They are automorphisms. So, I mean, we've kind of seen, you know, we've seen groups in the past where the elements are functions and the operations function composition, permutation groups. And yeah, back in chapter 8 or whatever it was, chapter 7, no, 6, ought G and in G. Is this like ought G? Well, this thing here is not a group. It's not even, we're not even thinking of it as a factoring either, though the notation's the same. Automorphisms of this thing, which are again ring isomorphisms from this field to itself, they're doubly operation preserving, that map every element of Q to itself. What? How would you possibly figure this thing out? Well, it's a fairly simple Galois group. It only contains two elements. The identity mapping, epsilon, and one other mapping, what should we call it? How about alpha? That's a common thing to use. Where what? What are the formulas for epsilon and alpha? They're functions. Epsilon is the function from Q adjoining root 2 to itself, is defined by mapping everything to itself. Take an arbitrary element of Q adjoining root 2 and map it to itself. what is alpha? I guess alpha must be something different. Otherwise, I wouldn't write it as something different. What's its formula? Give me an arbitrary element of Q adjoined root 2. What does alpha map it to? Well, if it's going to be in the Galois group, it's got to fix every rational number. What are the rational numbers in this field? Well, remember, A and B themselves are rational numbers, but because root 2 is not a rational number, for this entire expression to be rational, B would have to be 0. So if this is going to map every rational to itself, meaning elements where B is 0 to themselves, it's just the A, I guess it's got to start maybe with an A. And what else do I put if it's going to be something different than this? Maybe that? Like the conjugate? And yes, that is what you do. And this turns out to be a group under function composition, a very simple group. It's only got two elements. It's isomorphic to Z2. It's cyclic. I guess alpha must be a generator and its square must be epsilon. Let's check it out real quick. Is alpha squared equal to epsilon? By alpha squared, we mean compose alpha with itself. That is alpha squared of A plus B root 2. So this would give alpha of A minus B root 2. And yeah, do the minus sign on the square root of 2 part again. And you're going to get A plus B root 2, which is epsilon of A plus B root 2. I haven't proved that alpha is doubly operation preserving, though. You may want to spend some time thinking about, is alpha really a ring isomorphism? Is it onto and one-to-one as well? It is. It's fairly easy to prove that. So it's a two-element group. Well, why would we care about this two-element group? Again, this generalizes. It's going to relate group theory to field theory and studying roots of equations, field extensions. It's the fundamental theorem of Galois theory. That's what we're after. And that can ultimately, amazingly, help you prove that quintics are insolvable. Though we won't quite get to doing that. It's because it's too hard in the short time we have. Okay. All right. Have a good day.